Welcome to Inside Out, where we help you transform soul, body, and image. I'm Allison H. Larson, your soul expert. We've got the beautiful Lorena Joy Stewart, who is your body expert, and the glamorous Eugenia Battaglia, who's our image expert today. We have an amazing show coming up. We're talking about mothers and daughters here. It's our mother-daughter special. We've got some life-changing transformations in the way of makeovers, and you're going to learn about some young entrepreneurs. So stay tuned.
Recycling takes a team.
Why don't you let me
and me
help you out?
Everyone plays a part. Don't trash.
I love taking stuff apart and building new things out of it.
What could be treasure?
Pal's my most advanced Android.
This is awesome.
You haven't seen anything yet.
Give your cardboard box another life. Recycle.
Welcome back to Inside Out, where we help transform people's soul, body, and image. Today is our special mother-daughter edition, and we have a mother-daughter here with us today. We've got Lindy, who's 12, and Jenny, her mom, and they are the Stingers. And the amazing thing is that Lindy is an entrepreneur at 12 years old and has come up with what is every girl's dream, including mine. I was just telling you, when I was a little girl, I used to pretend I was a mermaid, and I would love to spend my summers that way. So tell me what you've created here. Explain these products to us.
So this is just like a swimmable mermaid tail that we've made, and we have manufacturers in China, and we just design whatever we want and they send it back, and it's amazing.
Great. So I love this concept. Now you've got the mermaid tail on, and show us what you've got on your arms here. So we all need these, and then you have your doll too. So great. And tell us what you're wearing, Jenny. What is this?
Well, this is really fun because it's our new product. We have mermaid blankets, and they are sparkly and they're warm, and I love curling up and reading a book every day in mine. So
okay, so you've got the swimming wear, and then when you get out of the pool, you need to warm up, you put on your mermaid blanket so you can keep the mermaid theme going. Well, I love it. So you opted to work with us to do this mother-daughter makeover, and we're going to dive more into that later in the show. But I want to know, why did you decide to do it? Why did you decide to do this makeover?
I don't know.
Do you think it's going to help you with your business at all?
Probably. It helps me feel more confident.
Helps you feel more confident? Great. Well, I think that's really important. So tell us, how old were you when you first had the idea? And tell me the story. How did you come up with this idea?
Probably when I was about 8. I loved playing mermaids when I was little. And I have 3 younger sisters, and I wanted to play with them and just like swim like mermaids. And so I asked my mom if we could make a swimmable mermaid tail that we could swim in and play in together as sisters. And she doesn't really like sewing, but we decided.
Neither do I. I don't blame you. I've tried to sew before. It just doesn't work for me. Yeah. So your mom couldn't sew it, but you have this amazing idea. So who ended up sewing the first one?
My mom and I worked together to sew the first one. And then wherever we went, everyone asked, like, where did you get these? And like, where can we buy one? And so we decided to start making them and selling them.
Amazing. So now as a mother, you're watching your daughter. She has this amazing idea. And I know as a mother of daughters myself, you want to encourage your children to be able to follow their dreams and their passions. So tell me what the process and journey was like for you.
Well, I loved the challenge of creating something and then seeing it in a package in a store. I wanted to see that happen. And so it's been a neat journey. I feel like we've just kind of been led to different people, and we found this incredible manufacturer in China that I feel like is our fairy godmother. Right. We just say, create this, and then we get it in the mail. So it's been a fun journey. We love working together on designs and
So do you ever have any disagreements? This is what I want to know. Having a couple of daughters myself, and you're 12, so you haven't quite hit the teenage years yet, but do you ever have any disagreements, or is it your idea and you support her, or how does that work for you?
Mostly everything we agree on, we just try and like debate on things like what's better for everyone, what things would people most like it.
Yeah, we just, for example, we're trying to design a purple to yellow mermaid tail, and right. we just got a sample in the mail from the graphic artist, and we both felt like something was off, and so we'll ask each other, what should we fix, and then we'll ask our design team, which is her younger sisters and friends. And
it really is a family affair.
Yep.
And how many younger sisters do you have?
Three.
Three younger sisters. So you've got three younger sisters. You've got you, you've got your mom all involved in this. I want to know, what has been the biggest benefit in, as far as working and doing this business? What's the message that you hope that people get out of this?
Our slogan is come swim with us. We want to just spread mermaid magic to everyone. We also now are able to donate one blanket for every 50 that we sell to primary children's. We're really excited to start giving to children right. that are in a crisis with something so magical that they can wear in their hospital bed. So now we're just saying, come swim with us and let's share with those that need it. We would love a little pick-me-up.
Okay, so my most important question for you so far today is, how do I get one of these mermaid tails? I want to fulfill my childhood dream. How can I get one?
So you could go onto our website, shimmertail.com, and or you could go to Amazon and just look up Shimmertail, and you can get one there too.
Right, and you do have adult sizes, is that correct?
We do, we brought you one.
You did? So, oh, thank you guys.
Yes, I would rather be in my mermaid tail mm-hmm. than just playing in the water without it. It is so boring without it, so I'm excited nice. For you to try it out.
Well, great. Well, I'm so excited to have you here. And coming up, we're going to learn more about Jenny. We're going to learn more about Lindy. We're going to talk about their transformation, soul, body, and image. And this really has been an incredible journey. And I know I've had an amazing conversation with you. We're going to talk about how to bring out that inner confidence and be able to reflect it on the outside to make you your best business card. And you mentioned that really did help boost your confidence. So stay tuned, because you are going to learn the tricks that they learned too. And we're going to learn more about this mother-daughter duo. So glad to have you guys here today.
Thank you, Allison.
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
Or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it. It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
I've got a job to do today.
Have a good first day at work, Mom.
Your donations to Goodwill fund job training programs right in your community.
Feels good to start fresh, right?
Sure does.
And like that, you're a job creator.
Eugenia Battaglia, welcome back to Inside Out. And we are here once again with Jenny and her cute little 12-year-old daughter, Lindy. And we went shopping, didn't we, to get you ready for the segment. And seriously, you are the youngest client I've ever dressed. Besides my little girls, you are the youngest. And I do have a daughter that's 12 years old, but you were so adorable. And I love that you, Jenny, you wanted your daughter to have this experience too, because you and I, we've had this experience maybe about a year and a half ago or so. You and your husband, we mm-hmm. went and worked together and shopped and for your closet and your guys' new image. And I loved how you felt that it was important that your daughter went through the same or a little bit of the same experience. So tell me, what was going through your mind? Why? Why did you want this? Yes, we're talking about your business, but why?
I feel like it's everyone's dream to know what looks good on them and to know what is my look. And mm-hmm. so to have Lindy at 12 have that and to be able to set that aside and be confident because of that, what a gift.
You're spoiled. You know that? I mean, that's pretty awesome. And I wish more moms or parents would do this for their kids, because it's from a young age, right? I mean, they don't teach us this in school. They mm-hmm. There's not a course for this, right? It's so important at a young age, especially with the styles out there today, to learn how to dress, how to present yourself, right? And with you had no idea, right? You came and you were wearing actually clothes that were too big baggy, for her, too baggy, baggy, right? Mm-hmm. And we kind of decided that you have this beachy look, right? This you could, she could model for Roxy. I mean, I said that for Hurley and Roxy, right? She's so cute. And so, did you remember some of the tips that I gave you in the mm-hmm. dressing room, and as I was picking out some clothes for you? Do you remember?
Some of the tips you gave me were, like, if it's too small for you, or if you, how you know if it, like, a shirt fits you, if it has to, like, come to here, the seam, and also, like, your pants have to fit you, something on your body has to fit
because
you.
Because you're really petite, but we went down a size to accommodate. It's not necessarily about what number you are in your age, so you're 12, and you were shopping in 12s, and like, okay, let's go down. Let's go maybe do 8-10s to accommodate to her small frame, right? And you felt so much better, right? You started standing up a little taller, and you loved. I could see when you'd stand in front of the mirror and you'd go, oh, I love it. I love how I feel so girly and so fun, right? Yeah. And that was great. I think we picked out some fun things. And this is one of them, right? This mm-hmm. cute little dress. How about you, Jenny? What was your experience? This was only our second encounter together.
Yeah. So my husband and I are both tall, and so we had a hard time. We just would wear tall clothes, but they were really baggy on us. My husband was wearing extra larges. We found out his real size is a medium.
Most men do that.
Yeah.
Most men wear things that are way too big for them.
And same with me. I've been a size 10 my whole life. I hate people that are a size 2. And you took me.
You
down
hate
to
people that are size 2?
Because I'm so like.
So all size 2 people, you hate them out there.
But you took me down to a size 4, and I was like, I hate people that are size 4. I'm a size 4.
So who do you love? Do you love anybody?
No,
you hate
everybody.
All people.
I just think you just gotta have what fits your body. That's what you need to
exactly.
wear. So and yeah. accessories. I'm really simple. I wear my wedding ring. And that's about it. And so you helped me this last time just to find a bracelet. I know you love gold. I was wearing all silver. It was just a lot of really good tips that way.
That's right. You showed up and you were wearing just jeans, which is fine. Great colored jeans, right? And you were wearing a button down, untucked. And just some basic flats. And you said, okay, how can I dress this up a little bit more? And I said, okay, let's tuck your shirt in. Add a belt, right? Which mm-hmm. was a gold belt, and then it just automatically just, and we could see your shape too. We automatically could see your small waist. We divided you a little bit, right? We changed your shoes, added some gold jewelry, and I could tell by the end of our shopping day, you were like looking in a mirror like, I look good. Mm. I really like it. You know, you started feeling a little different just by those small changes, right?
Yeah.
So what do you think this has done for your business?
Well, it's given us more confidence. My husband was able to sell his business, and he looked good all the way through that process.
Awesome.
For Lindy, what do you think it's doing for you?
It's definitely helped me feel more confident, and it's helped me to know like who I really am and what I look good in.
You're going to look at shopping a little differently, right?
Yeah.
Before you put whatever you want on next, you're going to go, you're going to think twice about it. And you're going to go down in a size a little bit, and you as well. Right? It's just a number. It doesn't matter what it is, mm-hmm. but as long as it fits you. Because you guys are beautiful. I mean, you're beautiful, mm-hmm. and you're so fun to work with. It's just a matter of really sticking to the rules. So, okay. Next, we will have Lorena come and join us. Stay tuned.
Than any other family.
My heart doesn't see race.
Even love is love.
Oh, look, a redhead.
Staring contest.
You still got it.
I know.
Come alive with the forest.
The dad was cute.
You were looking right at us.
Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you.
Well,
Welcome back to Inside Out. I'm Lorena Joy Stewart, your body expert, and we're here today back with Lindy and her mother, Jenny. Thank you guys for being here. We're going to do something we haven't done on this show, and that is we're going to go over the two-step process before sending them the workout and the diet plan. What I do is I go through blocks and then I get to a why. So you guys ready to do that here on camera? All right. So first, I want to talk to you guys about your anything stopping you, anything prohibiting you from moving forward before we start a workout plan, before we start a diet, and before we come up with a why. Is there anything that stops you, that's holding you back, that kind of itches at you, or something that an excuse for why you can't work out or eat healthy? Because we want to expose those things so we can crumble them up and throw them in the trash.
I have a hard one for you. So I have a three-year-old that loves to bake, and we bake cookies every day, or zucchini bread, and I eat it with him. So that keeps me from wanting to cut all treats out of my diet, because I want to be with him that way.
It's bonding time, mm-hmm. right? You get to spend time with your three-year-old. So for that, there's a lot of remedies. I am a sweet tooth chocolate-holic. I love chocolate chip cookies, and I've learned how to bake healthy cookies, and I'll send you some recipes. There's ways to integrate healthy. There's almond flour, which you probably use. Coconut flour?
No.
Oh my gosh, this is a life changer, guys. It's gonna change the game of baking. And there's also certain vegan protein powder that I like to use so I can get all my macros, protein, carbs, and fats, and not feel guilty. Yay. So there's a quick solution for that. Is there anything else? Anything for you?
Not really.
Are you addicted to soda or cookies or Cheetos or anything bad?
Not really.
No?
We took a year and challenged the kids, no soda for a year.
Oh, wow.
And if you do it, there's a money reward.
Oh,
so
wow.
She's doing great. In fact, she went off of sugar for a month just to try and up the reward. But then I was like, Lindy, we can just do soda. It's okay.
Oh, my goodness. That's amazing.
She's strong.
I don't know if I could even do that.
I could.
Is there anything else you'd like to talk about? You did mention something that, if you're comfortable, can we talk about
my husband is gonna die. So I, until I went to college, was so embarrassed about my big toes. I felt like they were like goofy toes that are like, you know? Yeah. And if anyone saw them, I felt like they wouldn't be my friend or like me.
Yeah.
And in college, I remember there was a boy I just loved, and I was laying down one time, and he came up and just grabbed onto my big toe, and I was like, you touched my toe. And then I realized, I calmed down, and even the next day, I was like, he didn't care. Yeah. He still thinks I'm a good friend.
He accepted you.
And I put that right past me. It didn't bother me. And my husband now has bigger toes than me, so now they're okay.
So for our viewers, to me, why that was such a powerful experience for you is because it's exactly what I do with my clients. We expose the fear. So once he grabbed your toe, okay, he was exposing the fear. You face the fear. And then once you face it and you expose it, you can crumple it up, throw it in the trash, and move on with your life without that gnawing at you or in your subconscious.
So that
is powerful. So hopefully people are listening or watching and they can look at their freckles or their big thumb or whatever it is, big ears. So we have a little bit more time. I wanted to talk to you guys about why. So, Jenny, tell me why. Why do you want to be healthy? Why do you want to take your body and your fitness to the next level? Because you seem pretty healthy. You have a good love for your body, good connection with food. You don't have anything stopping you from this point. So, what's your why?
Well, I want to be healthy so that I can live a long life with my husband, and that together we can travel and we can be healthy for our grandchildren and our great-grandchildren. That's the main goal. I want to live long.
That's powerful.
Yeah.
And that's why I will carry you through the times when you don't feel like doing what's right, because your why is powerful enough. It's not just for you. It's for your children and grandchildren and legacy. What's your why?
I've seen some people who aren't eating very healthy, and mm-hmm. they can't do as many things as they could do if they were eating healthy. And so that just makes me think that I have to eat healthy. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. Have you lost anybody, or you knew anybody that got really sick because they had a bad diet and they didn't take care of their bodies?
I don't know. My grandpa died from cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know if it was just because he wasn't eating healthy, but I think it was because of that.
So it's motivating to eat healthy, right? When we have people that we love that we lose. So thank you guys for sharing your whys, and I cannot wait to send you amazing diet plans and new recipes for healthy baking.
Yes.
And in the coming up next, we have affirmations with our yours truly, Allison Larson. Stay tuned. You don't want to miss it. She's going to help you transform your life.
So I've come up with the family emergency plan.
Great. What is it?
It's difficult to talk about, so I'm not telling you.
How will we know what to do?
You won't.
I'm so glad I won't have to remember anything.
And me too. Thanks for this, sweetie.
Talk to your kids about who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information.
Here is my handle, and here is my spell.
When I get all steamed up, then I shout.
Tip me over and pour me out. Oh.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life.
Cheers.
Take time to be a dad today.
Welcome back to Inside Out, where we're helping transform people soul, body, and image. If you're just joining us, this is our special mothers episode, mothers and daughters. So we have joining us here today, Jenny and Lindy. Now, Lindy's a 12-year-old entrepreneur. She's done some amazing things, has a wonderful, supportive mother in Jenny. And we kind of got deep the other day on the phone. We talked about some issues. How many of you feel like you get those negative voices or those negative thoughts, you get those things in your head telling you aren't good enough? Now, do you guys ever struggle with that?
Sometimes.
So what are the biggest negative thoughts that you hear that kind of affect your confidence?
Sometimes when I'm doing my hair, I just think, like, my hair doesn't look good, you should take it out and redo it, or your clothes don't look good on you, you should change, or something like that.
Yeah, and how does that make you feel?
It makes me feel sad sometimes, or just like mad at myself a little bit.
Yeah. And how do you think that affects you, like when you go outside or when you talk to people? Does it affect your confidence at all?
A little bit, yeah.
A little bit. So it's interesting because Jenny was on a conference call that I did the other day, and we talked about our lives being kind of like a tree. And sometimes our behaviors or the things we feel, not feeling confident, they're like the fruits of the tree. But really, we've got to get to the root of the issue. And oftentimes, the roots have to deal with guilt and shame and also fear. So what was your biggest one when we did that call? What was the one that you identified that you feel the most?
Sometimes I feel like a bad mom. Yeah. I feel like I've been too harsh with my kids, or I'm not using my time in the way I should to love them. So
does that make you feel guilty?
Yeah, I feel a lot of guilt.
Yeah. I definitely. So I identified with you in that way, is that I feel guilt too. And what happens when we feel this guilt, when we feel shame, and when we feel fear, it really prevents us from fulfilling our full potential, because those are huge roadblocks in our life. So something I suggested on the call, and something that you said that you shared with Lindy, was to replace those three things, to pick three ways that you want to feel. So what are the three ways that you chose that you wanted to feel?
I chose confident, valued, and energized.
So confident, valued, and energized. And you know, it's so interesting because I always think of, like, I remember being younger and seeing a Tom and Jerry cartoon. Do you know who Tom and Jerry are? You've got Tom, he's the cat, and Jerry's the mouse, and Tom chases Jerry all around. And one day Tom's owner was leaving and he said, "You just need to be a good cat." Well, as soon as the owner left, Tom has this shoulder angel and the shoulder devil pop up. And the angel's telling him, you know, "You're really good, you're amazing, you're confident, you're a great cat." And he has the shoulder devil telling him, "You aren't good, you can't do anything right, you may as well just go chase Jerry." Well, it's kind of like that in our lives. We have all those negative things, either through media or through friends, or just the thoughts that seem to pop into our head. Well, once we think about something, then we start to feel a certain way, and then that will reflect in our life. So it really is getting to the thoughts. So you've picked three ways that you want to feel. Do you want to know how to help yourself feel that way even more?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm going to teach you something called affirmations. So affirmations is when you say something out loud, and whether you believe it or not, after saying it so many times, it gets into your subconscious. Just like if you keep telling yourself you aren't good enough or you can't do something, then you'll start to believe it. If you tell yourself you are good enough and you can do something, then you're going to start to believe it. So what were your three things again?
Valued, confident, and energized.
So valued, confident, and energized. Okay, so I want you to stand up, because we always want to stand up when we say these things. So shoulders back, chin up. Okay, so I want you to say those three things, but I want you to say, I am, and then say them, okay?
Okay. I am valued, confident, and energized.
Awesome. Okay, one more time, and say even louder, and this time I want you to put your arms out.
Like this?
Nope. Hands open, arms up. Okay, now say it.
I am valued, confident, and energized.
Awesome. Okay, go ahead and take a seat. Good job. Didn't she do great? How did you feel saying that?
I felt energized and confident.
That's amazing. And there's something called power poses too. There's three key components when you're picking how you want to feel and you're telling yourself how you want to feel. You want the words, so you picked how you wanted to feel, you want to say the words. You want to use the right tone, so say it like you mean it. And then you want to have good body language. And actually, when you stand in these power poses, it releases a little bit of chemicals into your body that help boost your confidence. So you could feel that right as you were doing it. So if you're watching, I want you to think about, what are your three things that are maybe negative in your life, and what are three things that you could replace them with? So pick your three positives. And Lindy, how did you pick your three positives? Were they just things you wanted to feel?
Yeah, they're just things I wanted to feel all the time.
Good. And I think we all know that down at the core. What were the three things that you picked, Jenny?
I picked energized because I'm always tired as a mom. I picked calm because I don't want to be a frazzled mom. And I picked, what else did I pick? Oh, loving, because I want to give more love all the time.
And have you noticed a difference since you've been doing this? Have both of you noticed a difference?
Yeah, and it's weird, but it really is working.
Well, so. Great. Well, it really is. It's all scientific. It's all about getting into your subconscious and telling yourself who you want to be. So thank you so much, Jenny and Lindy, for being here with us today. Tell us one more time, for viewers just joining us, how they can get a hold of you, how they can get this wonderful blanket, the Shimmer Tail. How do they get a hold of you?
You can go to our website, shimmertail.com, or you can go to Amazon, too, to get one.
Great. Well, I look forward to sharing this information with my friends. Okay. And I heard you may have a little something for me.
Yeah, so we brought this for you. This is from our sister company, Serena Tail, and it's one of the swimmable mermaid tails.
So this is an adult mermaid tail? It's going to fit me? I'm going to relive my childhood dream. Thank you so much. And I have a gift for you, too. This is my book, Soul Intuition, and it talks about some tools like we've talked about today that you can use to really tap into your intuition and lead that confident life and fulfill your potential. So I wanted to give that to both of you. You'll have to fight over who reads it because I only brought one copy.
We'll be sharing this with everyone we know. Thank you.
What's your final message you want to leave with people today?
Well, come swim with us. And I love what you've taught about negative thoughts. I think that's going to change the world for so many people because negative thoughts hit us all every day.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Well, I appreciate having you here, and I look forward to all of you meeting our next Mother and Daughter Makeover.
You've messed up your son's haircut. Do you try to fix it? Work with what you've got? Or show solidarity?
Thank you, babe.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
I dare you.
I dare you to change the world.
Yeah, you. Getting that college education.
I dare you to be somebody important.
Like be a teacher.
Or a reality TV star.
I dare you to stand up here.
To call the shots.
To be a role model.
An inspiration.
An innovator.
To be a teacher.
Think you can change my life?
Make me excited about science like you?
Have a career that really means something?
Then do it.
I dare you.
Welcome back to Inside Out, where we transform you body, soul, and image. And we have our makeover guests here, mother and daughter, Jenny and Abby, back here on our show. How are you guys?
I'm doing great.
You look phenomenal. Before and after pictures, night and day. Your hair, she actually just had her hair cut in the studio in California. So, well, thank you for being here, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. So I would like to talk about your business, because your business is not the normal 9-to-5.
No.
You're not working. You're not a personal trainer. You're not a teacher. Can you tell us, tell our viewers what you do?
Well, my business is actually a Christ-centered energy healing company. I love to teach people about energy, and generally for Christian people, it's a topic they're not comfortable with,
yeah,
because they don't understand. And so I've just translated into words that they understand.
Yeah.
So instead of meditation, it's prayer.
Yeah.
And you know, and just teaching them in a gospel,
yeah,
arena.
And after talking to you yesterday, I got to hear a couple of cool stories about the transformation process that happens with a lot of your clients that come and, yeah, they have, whether it's sexual abuse or whether it's an eating disorder or it's business, you help get past all this mess and you make it a message. And that's really, yeah, what our show is all about. And how, yeah, do you do that? What inspired you to take on this career? Because you're a mother of how many children? And
eight,
mom?
And almost nine.
Okay, so
yeah, you're very busy. Yeah, we choose to homeschool our children. So we've got some busy things going on. But really, I feel like this is a calling I'm very passionate about, because, yeah, I've gone through my own healing process,
yeah,
my own transformation of starting to let go of things and limiting beliefs. And so,
absolutely,
that's a lot of what this deals with is we have traumatic experiences, and when we have that, we want to make some kind of sense of the chaos.
Yeah.
And so we take on these beliefs like, well, if that happened, I can, if I believe this, it'll keep that from happening again.
Yeah.
But it may not be true. And it limits us in our growth. And so helping people identify that and then putting in really positive, powerful beliefs,
yeah,
so that they can become who they're meant to be.
Speaking of powerful beliefs, I have your book here. It's called Over 1,000 Categorized Positive and Negative Beliefs, second edition. Mm-hmm. And just from reading this yesterday in my 5 minutes of flipping through, I was touched. I came across a page and my eyes began to water, and I was trying to hold back. Here I am trying to coach her, and I'm like, whoa, this is powerful. But it seems so elementary that I think a lot of people would overlook it without reading a book, you know, or having it in front of them. So can you tell our viewers about this amazing book that has touched me in 5 minutes alone?
Well, it's the easiest to use if you do something called muscle testing or applied kinesiology,
mm-hmm,
but really you can also use your intuition and,
okay,
be led to what it's designed and categorized. I don't know if you want to open it up,
mm-hmm,
into groupings, and it's organized according to chakras.
Mm-hmm.
Chakras are a bridge between our body and our spirit,
mm-hmm,
and they govern specific things. And so they're organized into those things. So like the root chakra is about your security or survival, actually being able to live.
Wow.
So if I were to find a belief in the root chakra in a certain category, and, mm-hmm, it's I'm not safe to feel my feelings,
yeah,
that would actually mean that they actually feel like I can't live if I feel my feelings, it's dangerous,
yeah,
to me. But if I were to find that same belief in the throat chakra,
yeah,
it would mean I'm not safe to express my,
wow,
feelings, because the throat is all about expression.
Wow.
And so it's, that's important, powerful, where it's found. But like I said, you can use it with intuition. But it's basically just categorized into different, you know, like a victim mindset or a control mindset,
yeah,
or maybe it's something stagnant, and then moving on, and then,
yeah,
and then there's a positive belief that can also be found to replace that negative.
Oh, that's wonderful, because it's hard to get rid of a negative belief without replacing it.
Right, I feel like it really creates a void, and we need to fill that with more light and knowledge of just like, so we can progress.
Absolutely, I love what you're doing, Jenny.
Thank you.
And Miss Abigail here, Abby, so what do? You're working, you're editing, you're passionate about editing and writing. Can you tell our viewers about what you do?
Well, I guess pretty much it's just like, hey, I wrote this thing and I need it edited. And so I edit, and you know, I make changes that you can see so that mom can go back through and say, you know what, I actually don't like that change because that takes away from my voice. Yeah. And so then she can go back and fix it. And because I think that's one of the most important things when I go through an edit, that mom's voice still needs to be there.
That's awesome.
Because that is powerful.
So I have two websites. And so Abby has edited everything that's on there. And we actually, one of my students was she's a BYU professor that teaches editing.
Oh, wow.
And when she came to my site, she said, I was amazed. There's like no errors. There are no errors. And I said, well, my 17-year-old daughter is my editor.
Oh, that's so cool. Getting an early start. Yeah. And it's great that you're finding what you're passionate about at such an early age. Mm-hmm. Coming up next, we're going to talk about their makeover process, soul, body, and image. We're going to dig deep, and we're going to go on the outside. We're going everywhere, head to toe. You don't want to miss it. Stay tuned.
Those dealing with the daily struggles of caring for a loved one, we hear you. That's why AARP created a community with experts and other caregivers to help us better care for ourselves and the ones we love.
What are you, superheroes?
Just four brothers who hate bullies and love this city.
Welcome back to Inside Out. We are here again with Jenny and her daughter Abby and our stylist Rosie. So, shall we talk about this enormous transformation? Here is her before picture, by the way, Jenny's before picture and Abby's. Okay, can I just start first with the hair, Rosie?
Yes.
Is that okay? Because I cannot believe, okay, I cannot believe you have not, or you've had a professional haircut in 16 years. Is this correct, or I'm making this up?
No, that's really
Am I exaggerating?
Yeah.
No? And Abby, you have never had a professional haircut. And how old are you?
I'm 17.
You're 17 years old. This is probably my most exciting makeover because it's such an enormous transformation. Now, there's only so much we could do because you are expecting your ninth child, and there's only so much I can do with that. I cannot hide that bump for the life of me, nor do I want to, right? But so tell me, what has your experience been so far? What do you think, Jenny?
Well,
I mean, this was a lot of transformation.
It was.
At once.
It was. And to be honest, it's secretly in my heart of hearts for years, I have wanted to have a makeover. I've wanted to have an experience like this. So it's been a gift, a true gift. And I grew up with a mother who always did her hair and makeup, and she'd say, we're going to go to the store. And then like 2 hours later, I'd be like, oh, when are we going?
I remember you telling me that.
And so I've gone to the opposite extreme where I brush my hair after I get out of the shower, and I don't do any makeup, I don't do anything, I'm ready to go.
So you went to the extreme. Really?
I did.
So a mother that took too long to get ready, and now you went to the extreme.
To the extreme.
Okay.
And so I really am happy. I want to find a middle ground of, you know, I've got 8, almost 9 kids, so I can't spend forever, but I would like to look nicer.
Which brings me to the next point. Rosie, before you worked with Jenny and Abby, we talked about about that specifically. So we want to ease her into this transformation. So why don't you explain our viewers a little bit about what you did?
Okay. Well, I spoke to you and you kind of gave me a heads up on, you know, what was going to happen. So when they came into the salon, the first thing that I noticed that, you know, they had really good energy and they had just these bright smiles.
Don't they? They're just glowing, especially now. I love it.
And thank you. As soon as they walked in, I knew what I was going to do to them. Awesome. You know, I was thinking, I mean, I envisioned this, so I was thinking of something immediately. So they came, they sat down with me, and, you know, we had a consultation. We talked about how her routine was, you know, what her daily maintenance was, you know, as far as her hair goes, because mm-hmm. she hasn't, you know, done it.
Because you don't want to go too drastic.
Yes.
Yeah. Right, exactly. At once. Right? Yeah. Because, right. Again, Jenny, you want to be able to maintain this. You're a very busy mother of nine, mm-hmm. almost.
Almost.
And you're running a business, and so...
So, exactly. So I had to make sure it was going to fit in her lifestyle. Mm-hmm. So that's my main thing. Whenever someone sits in my chair, I want to make sure that they're going to be able to maintain this style, you know? So what I did for her was try to come up with something where she was going to be able to maintain it. Even if she wasn't going to come back to the salon immediately, it would still look good. It would grow
out
nicely.
The color's beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
What kind of color? I love that color that you put on her hair.
Oh, thank you so much. Well,
and the layers, and it frames her face so much better. Because your hair was down to here, Jenny, is that right?
Yes, it was longer.
It was longer and just one line. Uh-huh. And how did you really cut? You used to cut your hair by yourself. Yeah. So explain to us again.
So you just part it down the middle when it's wet, and then... bring it forward and make it sure it's all straight.
And chop. Just chop. Okay. Okay. Well, you guys look amazing. And so also, let's talk a little bit about your clothing. Okay. What we did. So yesterday when we met, you were wearing a maternity bra, right? And you had
a nursing bra,
and you had been wearing it for how long now? A few months since your last baby?
Exactly. And I'm not nursing anymore.
Yeah. What was that?
I'm not nursing anymore.
You're not nursing anymore. So that was the first thing we did. We got you fitted. We got a bra fitting, mm-hmm. separated the belly here a little bit.
Yeah,
you
so
can't
that
really
I can
tell when you're sitting down. But then also because I think in general you wear clothing that's too big, right?
Yeah,
I think you're kind of accustomed of maybe being pregnant and not so happy with your body. And so you're wearing things too big, which in turn probably made you feel, I think...
Frumpy.
So we toned down the size.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. And even with this maternity dress, you wanted to go two sizes...
Yeah, I mean...
larger. And I'm like, no. Let's just because you're pregnant doesn't mean we need to have extra material. So anyway, thank you for being here. I hope you guys, and Abby, did you have such a great time?
Yeah, it was fun.
You look amazing. You're a teenager, you're 17, and this was just such a treat for you, right?
It was. Mm-hmm.
Explain to us a little bit about...
Well, it was kind of fun just to get a little bit out of my comfort zone, because normally I would not wear this, or especially the shoes.
The shoes?
The shoes are out there. I'm still not sure, but they're fun. They are
good.
Fun.
Good. Your friends are going to be jealous. Thank you so much for being with us. It was such a pleasure to work with you, and we will be right back.
Alvin and the Chipmunks want to remind you bacteria can hide in food and make you ill.
Wow.
But you can keep bacteria from ruining your day with four simple steps. Clean, separate, cook, and chill. The road trip to food safety starts at foodsafety.gov.
Hart, what's going on?
I'm leaving.
Why? What did I do?
Not enough. You constantly ignore me. You barely eat anything healthy. You're half as active as you used to be. The pressure is just too much. I quit.
Okay, I get it. I'll do better. Just please, don't leave.
Okay, but remember, if I go, you go.
Listen to your heart. Don't let it quit on you. Uncontrolled high blood pressure could lead to stroke, heart attack, or death. Get yours to a healthy range before it's too late.
Welcome back to Inside Out. I'm Lorena Joy Stewart, your body expert. And I'm here with our mom and daughter makeover guests, Jenny and Abigail. Thank you for being here. I'm so excited to get to speak to you guys about this transformation. And initially, I intended on doing a transformation with mom and focusing on mom
on her health, wellness, and lifestyle. But we started talking to Abigail and realized, wow, like there's a lot going on here, right? So the two-step process before getting into any workout or diet, we go over the two things, any blocks stopping us from loving ourselves completely, living confidently, and loving who we are so that we can step into a healthier us so we can love who we are right now, today. Do you mind sharing with our viewers the experience we had when we talked about the blocks and unshackling ourselves to the tree of, you know, the standard, the status quo of what beauty is, or guilt even, how, you know, you could feel guilty for not.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, I think one of the biggest things was actually accepting it for the first time, because it's something I hadn't told anyone before, that I had problems with self-image, because I knew that if I ever expressed it, my friends would be like, Abby, that's crazy.
Yeah.
And I would be able to say, I know what's crazy, but yet I feel that way.
Yeah. Your mom didn't even know. Your mom was shocked to know.
Mom knows that everything.
You had this
So that was probably the biggest thing, just accepting it and then realizing that a lot of it was comparisons and it wasn't necessary.
It's powerful.
Yeah.
And you know, here you are 17 years old, but there's 27-year-olds, 37-year-olds, 47-year-olds, 57-year-olds who are comparing themselves to other people. So what did we do? So we took up, we wrote a paper, we wrote down all the comparisons, all the lies, the guilt factor, the shame factor, the fear factor. We poured it all out on one page. And what did we do on the other side?
On the other side, I wrote a list of the things I loved about myself. And, oh, that was kind of fun to write, because it started off with just smaller things. And then it grew, I mean, smaller things as in, like, I do love my eyelashes, I do love my hair.
Freckles.
And then, yes, and freckles. I love freckles. And then it grew into the more powerful things, the things that are, like, make me who I am, like, that I am unashamed and also not shy of sharing my faith.
That's powerful.
And that is one of the things I love about myself, is that, and I'm able to be an example because of that.
Because of your audacity.
It's very humbling.
And your boldness. And it was powerful to see, when I read through, to see the things you wrote about yourself. And again, there's only one Abigail with the freckles right where you have them, with the eyelashes, and one Abigail that has that heart and faith to stand up and not be ashamed. I know when I was 17, I couldn't stand up. I was ashamed. So I applaud you for stepping into who you are and stepping into your fullness, because you will live a rich life doing that.
Thank you.
So I'm very excited. So we talked about the blocks. We removed the blocks. Then we talked about what you love about yourself. And I want to talk to you really quick. We have a little bit of time. We'll skip the why, but you said something to me backstage getting ready that really stood out. I'm, you know, here I am in LA and around where less clothes is more, or I mean, it, in the mind of consumers. But really, you're saying more is more, right? Can you tell 15 seconds?
Okay.
Tell our viewers how you feel.
I am really careful about what I wear. And so shopping, like, for clothes was hard because I like sleeves that are normally at least down to here. And I realized that it's not because I'm ashamed of my shoulders or ashamed of my body and showing it. It's because I want to veil my beauty, because it's precious to me.
That's
and
powerful.
It's not something that anyone has forced into me. It is something that I feel very strongly about. And I love myself, and so I want to keep myself pure, and pure for my husband.
That's so beautiful. And that is so refreshing to hear. I don't hear that often, and I'm sure a lot of viewers don't hear that at home. So Abigail, thank you for being so brave to come on the show to share your story and your transformation inside out. And coming back, we're going to share more inside out testimonies with Allison Larson, soul intuition, transformational woman. You don't want to miss it. She'll be right here right after this break.
Well, Thomas, you've got prediabetes. But with more exercise and a change in diet, it can be reversed.
I've tried exercising. It just makes me hungry for bacon.
I love bacon, too. And who really likes to exercise?
Not me.
Me neither.
Nobody. So we're good?
What? Oh, you still have prediabetes. Big time.
Welcome back to Inside Out, where we're transforming you, soul, body, and image. And joining us today is Jenny and Abby Rosengren. For those of you just joining, they're our fabulous mother-daughter makeover duo. So you guys look amazing.
Thank you.
But what I really wanted to talk about in this segment was more what's going on the inside. So let's dive deep into the soul. Now, you and I had a conversation.
Yes.
You've got 8 kids, 9 on the way, right?
Yeah.
And that's got to be a challenge, running your house. Is that?
It is.
Is it?
It is. And something that I've really has been, I mean, I help people to heal and get through their blocks. And
right. And
for me, I started to realize that as I would go out and I would create these classes so that people could heal in this loving, nurturing environment, non-judgmental, non-condemning, I realized that I could be that person. In fact, one of my students, and she said, "You're a gentle coach." And I realized I wasn't that at home.
Right.
And I needed to be able to bring that back to my home so that I could really be that true, loving, nurturing person.
Right.
And so we talked about.
Yeah, we did talk.
I'm gonna
fill everybody in on what we talked about. But first, I want to hear from Abby. Obviously, your mom's amazing. She does so many wonderful things. But you know, you probably see her get a little stressed out sometimes. Mm-hmm. Is that right?
Yeah,
a little bit. See, you're doing better than you think. What we talked about was acting rather than reacting, and this is something
right.
we specifically talked about. Now, when we're put in place in an environment, sometimes. Well, let me do this. Abby, put your hand in front of your face right here. Okay, now open your eyes.
Okay.
What do you see?
Like 3 random fingers.
So you basically see your hand. You see your fingers. Now, Abby, I want you to go like this to your hand.
Okay.
Now what do you see?
A very nice hand.
Very nice hand, but you can see all around you, right?
Yes.
Now suddenly your problem's not so big. So a lot of the times when we get in this environment, when we have an issue, say you had mentioned your house gets a little bit messy sometimes. I can imagine with 8 kids, but that seems like such a big problem. And we talked about stepping back and looking at that from a different point of view.
Right.
So the cycle that you go through, and let's just walk through this with you so that the people at home, so you listening at home can walk through the same process on your own. Think of a problem, think of a behavior, something that you're struggling with. What's your environment when you feel like you start to get a little bit stressed out about things at home?
Well, I become militaristic.
Nice.
and I'm not nice. I'm not patient, and I didn't want to have that kind of feeling in my home.
So how do you feel about yourself when you start to act
that way?
Oh,
I totally judge myself.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm harsh with myself, and then I think that naturally spills out and is even worse of an environment for my family because then that negativity grows.
Right. How's your self-esteem and confidence when you feel like you're being that militant mom when you're reacting to the problem at hand?
I mean, just not feeling good inside.
That definitely can affect your confidence, can it?
Yeah.
And when we're talking about building our inner confidence and our inner beauty, we want to act instead of react. So the question is, how do you get to that point? How do you act instead of react? And do you remember what we talked about on the phone?
We talked about really connecting to stepping back and that's what I do in my class is I step back and I listen to my intuition of where do I need to go with this instead of just knee-jerk reaction.
Yeah, so changing your perspective rather than viewing the problem, reacting to the problem at hand, seeing the full environment and also remembering who you are.
Right.
So what kind of a mother do you want to be?
Oh, I want to be loving, I want to be nurturing, I want to be patient and kind. They still need to. That doesn't mean they can walk all over me.
Right.
But understanding, I want them to respect me, truly. Okay. I want them to honor me. and feel like I want to do this for my mom instead of mom's going to get angry if I don't do this.
So the real key advice to learn how to act instead of react is just decide who you want to be, how you want to act, and then remember to take a step back when you get in that moment when that problem seems so big right in your face, just to step back and remember who you are and what you want to be. So thank you so much for sharing that with us. And tell us one more time, how can people get a hold of you that want to work with you?
Well, I have a website that's myperfectionhealing.org. I also have another website called crazyherbgirl.com. and my phone number, everything is they can contact me through that website.
Right. Thank you so much for joining us again. Jenny and Abby Rosengren, mother, daughter, beautiful makeover. And we really felt privileged and blessed to have you on the show. Thank you so much for coming. Stay tuned on how you can transform soul, body, and image.
Hey, look, it's those guys.
Are you good to drive?
I'm fine. Hey girl, what's the name?
How many did you have?
I should be fine.
You should be?
Go ahead and step out of the vehicle for me.
See ya, buddy. Good luck.
So turns out, buzz driving and drunk driving, they're the same thing. And it costs around $10,000. So not worth it.
Welcome back to Inside Out, where we're transforming you soul, body, and image. We've had an amazing show today with mother-daughter duos. And here joining us now, the beautiful Lorena Joyce Stewart, and I'm Allison H. Larson. And it really is all about learning from each other's experiences. And I know I learned a few things today. Now, you were sharing an experience that you had the other day.
So. Absolutely, yes. Yesterday. So this is, I want to leave you guys with this tip. I ran into a man at Starbucks. He is a private equity man and he's very successful. And he told me that he's been trying to fill this void in his life. He goes, we're all built with holes in our soul. And he goes, I tried to put cars, new girlfriends, and houses and yachts. And he said, and then I realized to just accept the hole, that I'm gonna live with this hole. I said, a lot of people must feel that way. If this man felt this way, how many more people in the world feel that they're just supposed to accept this hole in their soul? So I told him, I beg to differ. I believe that there's a solution and taking steps towards filling that hole. And it's not putting in toys, it's not putting in new boyfriends or girlfriends, it's not getting that new job. It's three things. I'm gonna go quickly here. One is being present. There's a gift in today. We can't be held back by our past mistakes or failures or things we've messed up on, and we can't stay stuck where we're at, obsessed with the future because it's out of our control. And we don't even know if tomorrow's gonna happen.
That's so true. Today's the most important day.
Today is the most important day, which leads me to being present, because if you're present, you're able to do what you do best, is connect.
Thank you.
Connect with people. And that's very important because a lot of people don't realize that they get hurt and damaged. So in trying to guard themselves and guard their heart, they actually harden instead of garden. Guard it. Guard it is what you need to do. And a lot of times we walk around with hardened hearts. So the third thing that leads me to is that we are spiritual beings. And to walk around with a corpse inside, if you're unaware that you are a spirit being, then you will feel an emptiness inside, because it's not just about our outside, our physical, it's not just about what we're wearing, it's not about what we have, but truly, if you're unaware of your spirit being, then you're gonna feel empty. So I challenge you to be present, I challenge you to connect and be guarded but not hardened, and I challenge you to get connected with your spirit self.
For more information on how to connect, for more great ideas, then tune into our shows in the upcoming weeks. We have some more guests that are going to share messages of hope with you, and that are sharing those messages of hope with the world. Thank you for joining us on Inside Out.